In this video lesson series, we're going to cover the trigonometric functions, and in part one, we do the definitions of sine, cosine, tangent, secant, cosecant, and cotangent. So to understand these definitions, let's take a look at an angle, theta, here in standard position, and the terminal side of theta goes through this point, and it has an x coordinate of x and a y coordinate of y. Now we know, of course, that the origin is at the point 0, 0. So then we would be able to find this distance r by using the distance formula, which you remember from your algebra class. So we would end up with the square root of the quantity x minus 0 squared plus the quantity y minus 0 squared. So that is going to turn into the square root of x squared plus y squared, and that is the definition of r. Now, also from your algebra class, you may remember that the square root of anything we refer to as the principal square root is always greater than or equal to zero. And now, since r is a distance between two points, distance is always positive, so we know that r will always be a positive number. Now let's get into the definitions of the trig functions. Sine of theta is defined to be the y-coordinate divided by r. So it is a ratio. All the trig functions are just ratios involving x and y and r. Cosine theta is defined to be the ratio of the x-coordinate of the point divided by r. Tangent of theta is defined to be the y-coordinate divided by the x-coordinate, and of course x cannot be 0 because it's in a denominator. Now we didn't have to say that for sine or cosine because we already know that r can never be 0 because r is positive. Moving over to the next column, we have cosecant of theta is defined to be r divided by y, and so of course y cannot be 0. Secant of theta is defined to be r divided by x, where x cannot be 0. And finally, cotangent of theta is x divided by y, where y cannot be equal to 0. So there's the definitions of the six trig functions. In this first example, we're told that the terminal side of theta goes through the point 12, negative 5, and then you have to find all six trig functions of theta. It's CYU time, so pause the video, work the example on your own, then restart the video to check your answer. Okay, let's see how you did. So the first step would be to plot the point, which we know is 12, negative 5. We could sort of approximate that here. We know the x-coordinate is 12, the y-coordinate is negative 5, and we know that the terminal side of theta has to go through that point. So we know this is 12, comma, negative 5. Now recall the definitions that we just learned, and we're going to need x and y and r. Well, we already have x, we already have y, so the only thing left we need is r. And we know the definition of r is that it is the square root of x squared plus y squared. So we plug that in, we get the square root of 12 squared plus negative 5 squared. So we've got radical 144 plus 25, which is the square root of 169, which is 13. So now we know that x is equal to 12, y is equal to negative 5, and r is equal to 13. So now it's just a matter of plugging into the definitions. We know sine of theta is defined to be y divided by r, so that's going to be negative 5 divided by 13. Cosine of theta is defined to be x divided by r, so that's going to be 12 divided by 13. Tangent of theta is defined to be y divided by x, so we have negative 5 divided by 12. Cosecant of theta is defined to be r divided by y, which is equal to 13 over negative 5. And of course, with any fraction, you know that the negative sign could either be in the denominator, the numerator, or out front. So it's also perfectly fine if you write this as negative 13 over 5. It's fine to leave it like this, or fine to leave it like this. Secant of theta is defined to be r divided by x, so we get 13 over 12. And finally, cotangent theta is defined to be x divided by y, which is equal to 12 divided by negative 5, or as we said a minute ago, you can write that as negative 12 fifths. And here's the six trig functions of theta.